Let's think about higher dimensional Gaussians for a few moments. There should be a nice way to express these, maybe using vectors, right? Right. Let's consider a standard Gaussian on Rn. If it has mean zero, and let's say the covariance matrix is the identity, so unit variances and no correlations between any of the variables, then this expression is 1 over root 2 pi to the n times e to the minus 1 half norm of x squared, or if you like, e to the minus 1 half x dot x. Now, in order to be a probability density, this has to satisfy the property that when we integrate it over all of Rn, we get 1. Is that true? Yes, of course. It's true, and it's a simple extension of what we did back in chapter 13. If we integrate this over all of Rn, I can pull out that normalization constant, and I'm left with the integral of e to the minus 1 half x dot x. Now, expanding that out, that exponent is minus 1 half quantity x1 squared plus x2 squared all the way up through plus xn squared. And I'm integrating with respect to dx1, dx2, up through dxn. Now, by the Fubini theorem, we can expand that out and break it up into a product of n single integrals over the reals, where using a dummy variable, smiley, this is e to the minus 1 half smiley squared d smiley. Now, we've done that integral before. That's a one-dimensional Gaussian that has integral square root of 2 pi, and that is where our normalization constant comes from, because we had n of those. Okay, so that's that. What about a more general Gaussian, where we have mean at some location, mu, in Rn, where we have an arbitrary covariance matrix, V? Well, this expression is going to be a bit more complicated. Stick with me on this one. Here's the formula for a general Gaussian. The normalization constant is 1 over square root of 2 pi to the n times the determinant of the covariance matrix. Then we have e to the minus 1 half x minus mu transpose times v inverse times x minus mu. Now that exponent, that's really a quadratic form using the inverse of the covariance matrix, something often called the precision matrix. That normalization constant is similar to what we saw in the standard case, but now it incorporates the determinant of the covariance matrix. Now, this is a complicated formula. You have to think about it to really get it inside your head. But if you compare it with the one-dimensional formula, things match up nicely. Using a quadratic form in that exponent and using the inverse of the covariance matrix is a really great way to generalize the simple one-dimensional case. The normalization constant makes sense. I'm not saying you have to memorize this formula, but let's think about what it means and what it looks like. Because what's nice about Gaussians is that you only need to know the mean and the covariance, and everything else looks nice. Let's say we look at some pictures in the plane. Let's say we have a standard Gaussian with covariance, the identity matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. Well, if I were to look at level sets of this, this would be circles about the mean. In general, one of the things that's really nice is that level sets of a Gaussian are ellipses. So if I have a different covariance matrix, maybe one with a positive covariance between the two variables, then I would get ellipses that tilt to the upper right with a positive slope. If I had negative covariances between the variables, then I would have a negative slope for my level set ellipses. And the eccentricity of these ellipses depend on how strong the correlation is between the variables. Now, if you maybe suspect that there's some deeper linear algebra going on here between the matrices in these pictures, you are correct. But I don't quite have enough room to explain all that. The thing that I want to get across is that knowing the mean and knowing the covariance matrix is all you need to work with a Gaussian. And this is why Gaussians are so useful. If you look at, say, the graph of a Gaussian function, you have the peak right at the mean, and then the way that these ellipses, these level sets, are arranged about that mean just depends on the covariance matrix.